This is what MongoDB looks like in CodeScene. The way to read this visualization is by looking at the hierarchy, because this visualization follows the structure of your code. So, if this is one of your codebases, you will recognize the names of these circles as important subsystems or high-level components. This is an interactive visualization, so you can click on any area of interest and zoom into the file level. When you do that, you see that CodeScene visualizes each file as a circle. Some of the circles are pretty large, while others are much smaller. This is because the size of a circle reflects the number of lines of code in that module. You can also see that CodeScene uses different colors for different files. These colors reflect the code health metric, which is the industry-leading code quality metric. CodeScene has categorized some pieces of code as being healthy. This is where you want to be with the majority of your code, because healthy code is code that's easy to understand, easy to maintain, and easy to develop further. You can also see that there are large problematic parts in this code base. Problematic code is code that's more risky to work with, it's easier to introduce defects to, and it represents an increased risk that the task will take much longer than anticipated. And of course, unless you're careful, you might end up in the unhealthy category. This is code with severe degree of technical debt. Looking at the Mongo code base, you can see that there's a lot of unhealthy code. And the question is, of course, where do we start to pay down technical debt, because we cannot fix all of this red code at once. This is how CodeScene sets itself apart from all other tools on the market, because CodeScene is able to prioritize your technical debt based on how you, as a team, work with the code. We call this refactoring targets, so let's click there. What CodeScene did now was, it took all this red code and looked for prioritized refactoring targets. Before we look deeper at that, we need to understand how these priorities are possible. So, let's take a different look at Mongo. What you see here is a descriptive data of a code base. The x-axis here shows each file in the system, sorted according to the change frequency. That is, how many times we have made a commit to a specific file. What's so interesting about this visualization is that we see that it forms a power law shape. This means that most of your code is here in the long tail, but most of your development activity is in a much smaller part of the code base at the head of the curve here. We can even zoom in further. What does this mean when prioritizing technical debt? Well, it simply means that even if you have some red code here in the long tail, that means it's technical debt with low interest. It's technical debt that you can most likely live with. However, red code at the head of this curve is likely to be high-interest technical debt. It's going to be very expensive due to the high change frequency of that code. CodeScene's refactoring targets simply tap into this development information to come up with priorities that make sense for you. Let's dig into one of these refactoring targets to demonstrate it. We'll pick this one in the repo. This is a file called replication coordinator impl. If you click on it, what you'll see to the right is information that describes the content of this file and its code health score. The first thing you might want to know is, why is this code unhealthy? Why isn't it green? The best way of getting that information quickly is via our virtual code review. So if I click on review here, CodeScene performs a full virtual code review, where it lists all the code smells that we identified, which are making this code unhealthy. All of these code smells have the same format. First, we always have a where section, where we point you to where in the code is this particular code smell, so you can inspect it. Then, we explain how we measure it, and why this particular code smell is a problem, so that you know what you're looking at. After that, we want to make it actionable by explaining how to fix it. This part of the explanation often includes a refactoring suggestion, so that you know how to take the red code, turn it green, and remediate the code smell. Of course, CodeScene also offers high-level dashboards so that you can follow your progress over time. This is what it looks like in Mongo today, where you can see that there are a bunch of different code health scores. One of the interesting ones is average code health, which shows you what this code base looks like overall. So it's a weighted average across all files in the code base. The most important KPI is the hotspot code health. Hotspots are the refactoring targets at the head of the curve. If you manage to take these hotspots and turn them green, then you are very, very likely to see a real impact and benefit on the velocity of your future development. Of course, you can see the long-term trends here, or how your code health has evolved over time. You can zoom in on the latest month, for example, and see that, indeed, you seem to be on the right track toward improvement. When it comes to prioritizing technical debt, the CodeScene philosophy is that trends are much more important than absolute values. So instead of staring blindly at the KPI like this, you want to know if you are doing better or worse. One way of looking at the hotspots is to simply pull up the visualization of the code health in each hotspot. When you do that, you can easily see hotspots that degrade in code quality. So here's one example of a file called op-op-server-impl. Over the past year, this file has degraded in code health. This means that this file is now harder to work with and more expensive to maintain than it used to be. Acting upon the recommendations that CodeScene gives allows you to reverse that trend, and you can see an example here in this file. Over the past month, the development team has managed to improve the code health from red to the yellow segment. This type of information is excellent to include in your project retrospectives to celebrate the victories and make sure your technical debt is well managed. While these trends are super useful to inspect on a weekly basis, how do you manage technical debt in your daily development? Because we know that the earlier you can discover new technical debt, the quicker and cheaper it is to act upon it. For this purpose, CodeScene offers a complete automated code review as a part of your pull requests. Here's an example of what that looks like. While this is on GitHub, we do support all other Git providers as well. Here you can see that the developer opened up a pull request. The moment that happens, CodeScene goes in as a bot and reviews that pull request. In this case, you can see that CodeScene claims that our code quality gate has failed. The reason it failed is because code health is declining in four files. You can see this summarized here. So we're introducing a complex conditional, duplicating code in one of the code smells, and so on. CodeScene also acts as a human reviewer, pointing out where these code smells are happening and what you can do about it. So all you need to do is click Read More, and you will get direct tips and guidance on how to resolve this code smell so that you can merge clean and healthy code. Thanks for watching.